everyone. Dave, Display Fireworks 1. I'm here in Monessen, Pennsylvania. Check out a store that's selling, in addition to my stuff, a multi-brand store. Mom and pop stores here in Pennsylvania. It's called B&D Fireworks. So let's go in and take a look. We're inside the store. It's a small store. It's a mom and pop store. Now, just to update you how things work here in Pennsylvania, fireworks became legal, the full line consumer, in 2017. And to sell the full line, you have to have what's called brick and mortar store. So anything with tents in Pennsylvania is safe and sane only. So it's a multi-brand store. So I always like how people set the stores up. It's always fun to check out. So here, as soon as you come in, firecrackers. Always a good start. And of course they have my roll of firecrackers here. And at the bottom, Cherry Bomb brand. This is nice to have multiple brands to come in. And you'll recognize some of the names here as we go. All right, come on, let's check out over here. What's funny is I go in some stores and they start out with the 500 gram cakes. I always think it's good, you know, there's probably some retail strategy to it, to start with the smaller items, less expensive items, then you kind of work up to it. See little individual things. Boy, that's a heavy smoke right there. Little fun toy items. Now here's kind of a wedding theme. Heart-shaped sparklers, etc. Now, you know, some of the people, at least here in Pennsylvania, were telling me they're having a hard time getting some of these sparklers. You know, Diwali was kind of big this year, and something with the sparklers. A lot of sparklers went. Something new, a couple companies coming out with a sparkler and a glow stick bracelet or whatever you could put on together after you're done with the sparkler. Kind of a combo thing. Let's see. Oh, look, they're selling a big shell on the retail shelf. No, it's a fountain. Now, Winda, I demoed some of these products. I do demos for some of the firework companies if they can get it to me. And I actually think I have more stuff coming from Winda. I shot this one last year. It's pretty good. So this is kind of a safe and sane ground-based fountain stuff, you know? You know, at one time, this was like all we had in Pennsylvania, but now we kind of got a little bit of everything, which is always nice. Some of these can be a real good value, I'm going to be honest. Like this, for years, this Super Stallion, my brother's, has always been a great cake. And, you know, you fill it, the tubes are solid. You just get a whole case of these, I remember. Always good value. These 200 gram cakes. All right, let's keep going. Oh, look at this, something for the ladies. Princess parachute. Now, if this was the boys, airborne paratrooper, okay? That's nice. I used to have a cake that I would shoot at my sportsman's club with all these parachutes, and then they would land, and then I would say, wait a minute to all the kids, let it cool down, and then everybody go pick it up. So always nice to see a little something for the ladies come around too. Here's some, oh look, all parachutes. Double knife parachute, been around for years. Here, this is a multi, wow, 250 parachutes. Are you kidding me, daytime? Wow, that's, I'd love to see how they do that. They probably stringing them, you know. I'm just like seeing some of this for the first time coming in. Just like when I was a kid, you could just have fun forever with these. Look at all them bottle rockets. And very few people remember this. Like way back in the day, there was a state that allowed bottle rocket sales, but it couldn't have a report. And I was traveling with my family when I was young and picked them up, and it would just, and that was it. No boom. And I forget what state it was, so you could tell me in the comments. Individual firecrackers. Just a little pack at a time. Yeah, strings. And of course the big one. Okay. Let's turn the corner and check something else out. Single shot items. Usually, people in retail usually like these little more expensive item. And someone new that doesn't really want to deal with the reloadables sometimes will buy these. I've seen people when they start to advance and they really don't know a lot, they'll get like about 10 of these and just bolt them all down and try to fuse them together kind of thing. But there's a market for it. Whoever shoots these, please tell them to be careful. You need some good clearance to get them out there. And most of the time they'll go straight up, but if there's a little angle on them, be careful. Oh, look, I haven't seen this kind of thing in a while, little individual rockets. Too. Set them on the ground, spin, light them. This has been around for a while. It's hard to believe something like this, just kind of can get up there and spin in the air. All right, let's come up to the room cam, please. I always like Roman candles. I mean, in all honesty, they're a great value, and it's just, you just brace them into a thing of sand or something and shoot them up in the air. And then once you start, it's like once you start advancing, you're like, hey, I'm going to get a little fancy, right? Try to do a little something like this. Usually people that start advancing into pyro start to do that because it's easy, it's cheap, and you can be a little creative. There's like this kind of thing. I mean, you just have a blast with that, Just like all these shots. I know there's a restriction for how many it could shoot, how much it could hold. It would be nice to just get one, probably in other countries they have it. One big massive candle that shoots all these balls. Yeah, I've had fun with this kind of stuff. You get a little pyro fix in the backyard late at night, doesn't have to go boom. Okay, some more. That name's been around for years. Battle of Colors. Some years are better than others. We're into gender reveal. This has gotten really big over the years. And I remember, like, if I had to give a prize away for, like, an innovative idea in this line of this kind of a product, gender reveal, I would say it was Winda. Because, and here's why. Everybody came out with this gender reveal. Like, think about this. You're going to show up at the party and go, guess what, everybody? We're going to have a gender reveal. And we're not going to tell you what it's going to shoot. But see, everybody can see it. They know the color. They know what it is. And I mean, I picked up on it right away. I'm like, the ideal thing is you probably buy, like, two of these things. Like this one here from Winda. You buy two of them, and you set this on the table inside the house, and you have one out in the field. And then everybody's like, oh, no, you'll know when we shoot it what it's going to be. And there's, I don't want to reveal it, there's a secret code here you have to know when you buy it that will tell you and no one else. So, and I'm like, Winda did it, and I couldn't figure why no one else figured it out. That you don't want the outside of it to reveal because people will see it ahead of time. Okay, we're starting to get a little bigger products here. Some down below. Here's one of mine. This is the new version this year. And they have a whole display of my stuff here. I'll show you in a second. It's smaller this year. And I think it's louder. And I think you'll like it. You tell me if you had the old one and you get this one. And remember, all my products, except for one, I'll tell you over here, have the secret port. You could use it if you want or not use it. This is for people with the firing system. Okay, rockets, Roman cam. All right, here's back wall. Still smaller stuff, priced whatever. And now we go into the next room. This is like so typical mom and pop stuff. Of course, I got to show you my stuff. You see I'm on an end cap, right? I'm not in there all mixed up. I'm at the end here, showcased. One of his, he's, the owner here is a, local entrepreneur that has different ventures going. He has someone to paint a sign and put it up here, and I thought that was a nice touch, so thank you. Here's my stuff here. Of course, the original OG. I can't get them to put the port in, all right? I don't know what you're worried about. I want that port in them things, and I don't know why they won't do it, but they won't. This has the port. All of these have the ports. Recursion. Here's the combo pack. If you're in retail, you can get the combo. Three different ones, Big Air Time, Six Shooter, Wolf Moon. All in one case, that's it. One of the more popular ones here, Storm Surge. I went to a store here locally to do a tour. You know, it's easy. I live in Pittsburgh, so if there's something close, I could do pretty easily. And I went, and they had it all hidden behind something. I'm like, well, how are you going to sell the Storm Surge if it's hidden? They're like, no, people want it. We're hiding it for some of our more special pyros. So everybody likes this kit. I think you will, too. And it has the port. If you have a firing system, Willow Beach, different version this year, a little smaller, but still good, nice sound. OG has been around, and guy in Tennessee, Rod's Fireworks, sells the hell out of it. Yeah, Recursion, something different, shape, etc. And you can see I have the Cobra. The little subtle secret to let you know that for the people with the firing systems. The two cakes that are missing, they won't come until after July 4th. And it's a shame because they're pretty popular. Spooky Staircase and Backyard Battlefield. Actually, I had fun making that Backyard Battlefield artwork because it kind of typifies what a lot of us go through as pyros. So if you get a chance, look at that artwork. So unfortunately, it won't be in until after the 4th. All right, there's me. All right, let's keep going. See different brands, Brothers, Linda, Firehawk. This is what's nice about a mom and pop place. 500 gram cakes, it looks like. And here's the 9 on the boards. For a while, we thought they weren't gonna keep making them, but they do, they did. People enjoy it. They buy these, you know. Probably it's a good retail seller. Here, right here. This is, when I first saw this kind of thing advertised, look out here, 15 gram finale. Okay, now we all know in the business you can't make one big 1500 gram cake in the United States. So I'm thinking, how did they put it together? How do they do this? Do they have like little ways one attaches to the other? Here, I'll show you. It comes with this, which is basically all three fuses together, it looks like. And see how it's set up on an angle. So you light one, all three light. So that technically is 1500 gram. All right, artillery shells. This is like if it's a smiley face or not. And I don't know about this one. It's a Sky Bacon product. But I know, like, professionally, when I would do, like, a pro show, and then you would see that, and they probably marketed it when they sold the show, like, the heart-shaped shells. And I would always try to shoot them. When I was out in the field, I'd put tape on top of the mortars of the heart shapes. So in the dark, I would know which one. I'd tell everybody, stop, okay, hit the heart shape. So you shoot three of them in the air and hope somebody sees one of them. Because you never know how they're going to break. So this face may be like, yeah, it may be all over the place. So don't expect a smile every time. Somebody else may see it, not necessarily you. So shoot a bunch if you can. If you have a rack, just shoot a group of them. And then everybody get a little smile, maybe. Ball shells, still around, still popular. Multi-breaks here. I did a New Year's Eve finale with a bunch of these Shogun ones. They were double break, triple breaks, and I just had them all and just lit a bunch, and with some of my cakes and the finale of that, I thought it went pretty well. You know, there's certain effects that you can't get in a canister, that can only come in maybe this. Now, as far as I know, they don't have happy face canister shells, you know, so it's probably easier to make if it's circular. Okay, here's, oh, here's mine. Here's mine this year. Whoop. Got my YouTube reference. People follow my videos, come in, ask for them. And we can knock Dave's sign down. And little mini shells, reloadables. You know, if all goes well between now and July 4th, I'm going to teach a class to some teenagers about how to shoot fireworks. And I thought one of the ones I should probably cover is the reloadable shell, at least how that works. I think it'd be a, you know, a great like focus group to someone that has never shot to say, do you know what this is? How does it work? Just the, there's no real education sometimes in this business. So I'm taking a little shot at it here and there. Like I teach somebody about the ATF license, I'm going to try to teach teenagers about how to safely shoot these products. A little bit at a time, of course. Okay, canisters. I don't know if this one's new this year. This one. This is a brand, Spirit of 76 brand. And of course, everybody's, every store, people come in and look for these. Shells, Excaliburs. When I brought these in, you know, to market, I tried to not compete with this, you know, at this time anyway. Something in a different variety, different price. See, in this category to compete. Because the retail customer is the real customer, you know. Us advanced guys, we'd like to just get rid of all this box and just buy the damn shells, right? But, you know, the rules are the rules. Like, you know, there has to be, you know, one mortar tube per each, how many shells, etc., the packaging, all of that. Okay. Probably has this year just to get some people excited. This kind of thing here is good for you know, someone like the dad comes in or something and just doesn't know what to buy, and you know, maybe get this whole big thing right here. Alright, that's all. Here's some more here. It's fun. There's a lot of different brands. It's great. A lot of different brands. Sounds like a good name. Dancing Rainbow. Yeah, some of these I know and some I don't know. Alright, there it is. There's a little short tour of the store. It's located in Monessen, PA. I'll put a link to his store in the description of the video if you're here locally out of Pittsburgh. And I'll also put a link to my website that shows everyone that's selling the Display Fireworks 1 product. Now you may see it out and about other places, but like to get listed there, they have to carry like most of it. It's kind of the rule. So, all right, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next video. We're coming up on a July 4th holiday.